Alright. Tonight, okay, I'll show you my bread first. This is a what kind of a bread? Oh my gosh. See, I severed it too much there in the middle. It's kind of a sour whole wheat. I'm not getting a good lift though from it. Here you can see the inside. I'm not getting a good lift. It could be the feet were like 5,000 feet here. Because I'm adding yeast, and then I'm also adding the sourdough mixture from the refrigerator that keeps growing, and it's still not really rising, but it does give a nice sourdough taste. But I recommend any of that to add like seeds to it, sunflower seeds, walnuts, something. So it's not just bread. But anyway, what have I been up to? I'm at this Jed Comery, and I'm in this name, Ruth Devonshire, and she is a mess in the line because her supposed mother links through to Penelope. Now, Penelope Devereux. Now, Penelope Devereux, the wife of, she's also the Countess of Devonshire, the wife of Charles Blount, of Devonshire, the first Earl of Devonshire. Okay, so it's very exciting, you know, to get to this group. Well, oddly, they're not really direct descendants of a king right away. They're just kind of like the court people. And so far, I haven't really found like anything stupendous with them, just that they have beautiful costumes. And that's kind of neat, just to find them in the regalia. However, I am still not good with the direct link through. Ruth is causing a problem. But I can still give a little history of Miss Penelope herself. She was married to Rich. His name was Rich. I can't remember the first name, but her name was originally Penelope Rich. And in all of the fun of it, they had an estranged marriage, and she just whisked herself off to this Charles Blount. Oftentimes they give him another name, and I'm missing it, and it's something very catchy. But she whisked herself off to him and started having illegitimate children. She had apparently 6 illegitimate children. All right, out of wedlock with Charles. Most of the time while she was married to this other. So Penelope Rich was a problem, because when it came time around Ruth, apparently she gave birth to Ruth. Now Ruth married Christopher Tilghman, who is one of my ancestors in the links. She married Christopher Tilghman, and this is the daughter, and she was born around 1600. So everything is like looking good, and she's out there on this wiki tree, she's out there on the genie, she's on a lot of these things, and yet I cannot see her on this family search. So I put her there today, I added her there, and I took away Anna Pendroth. Anna Pendroth was listed as a woman who was 20, 25 years older than her husband. And I think back in 1500 that just would not have happened. So I deleted her out. I just think that was an impossible record. And so I put the Anna, Miss Penelope. Miss Penelope though also had another name, Stella. Stella, she was named in fun jest after Stella, the star search constellation. Very fun, because Stella is, I'm finding with genealogy, some of the names just filter through and they're easier to say, or they're easier to just name your dog after. You know, all of these things, you know, they're like, oh my gosh, Stella, of course. You know, the name of my brother's dog was Stella. And so the you know, those things are just so easy, easy to do, you know. So certain names just keep repeating themselves. Now, so back to Ruth. Ruth is the trouble, because there she is, Ruth Devonshire. She is born approximately 1600, and we don't have a birth record. We don't have barely any records, unless I can sign up with another record firm that costs money. But this, what do we call her? She is a missing link, of course, but she's not a missing link because she's already out there. They have her on Wikipedia. She's already listed as one of the illegitimates. She's there. So we know that she's there on WikiTree, we know she's there on the Genie, we know about her. It's just getting the sources, you know. Getting the sources for her Christopher Tilghman and Ruth to have, so her mother is Penelope and her father is this Charles Blount. And I'm like, well, because they're neat. They are neat. Well, I'll talk about Charles. Now, what did he do in his life? Well, he traveled to the Netherlands. He did some little bits early in his life in the 20 age range with Queen Elizabeth. He was in her court. She even paid him a little bit of money sometimes. $200 for things occasionally. I'm not really sure why. But he was on her money dole out. And oddly, this same Charles Blount, this is the Scottish line, this family that I'm talking about is my Scottish line. So he also was a visitor with the King of Scotland. So when he was visiting with the King of Scotland, he was in the group that mingled with the Scottish kings. So this is very wonderful. So this brings it all, ties it back into the Scottish group. Now, this same group, if you go into Charles Blount's will, we have Berkeley there. He had like maybe 10 people as executors for his will. He had a lot of cash, I guess. However, it was all when this whole thing went down with the illegitimate child and then children, and when the marriage of Mr. Rich became a divorce with Penelope. It was very unheard of. He divorced her. He went to court. He divorced her. She embarrassed him to such a degree that none of her children were ever allowed to carry a title. Not one of her illegitimate children. So while all of this is going on, Charles Blount is still, you know, wheeling and dealing with the Armada. He's out there as one of the major players with this Spanish Armada, trying to be part of the war against it. So all of this is happening. And yes, Penelope is a redhead. She looks like a blonde on the site, but she is a redhead. She has a sister. They look like twins, her and Dorothy. Now, when they are in there, they're about to die now. I have Charles Blount, in the last 5 years, like almost 5-10 years, he gets a lung infection. He is feeling weaker and weaker and weaker, and he dies. from a lung infection. Supposedly, though, he caught that in his last year. And it was just after he officially married her. Just after. He had already had fathered all these children, though. So they were all quite young. All of the children were very young. So this may be where Anna Pendrith came into the picture. Maybe she helped raise them after as a surrogate mother, because little darling Penelope died a year after Charles died. So all of these very young children, we're talking 6 years old, 5 years old, all, even one and two, all of them didn't have a mother any longer. So it would have been a big deal. They would have had to find a surrogate mother. So that would help if we could locate that surrogate mother. Gosh, it's such a puzzle, isn't it? I did find a lot of good information, though, out at the Parliament. The UK Parliament site has very much good information regarding Charles Blount and his Dantria Penelope. Penelope Devereux, Countess of Devonshire. Okay, so what else did I learn about Penelope? She danced. She was a dancer. She danced. Where did she dance? I don't know. There was something that she danced for. It was some get-together, and she played a part. She played a role, and she was a dancer, so that was kind of fun. To find her as a dancer. Oh my gosh, but yeah, they both died young. They were in their 40s. So Penelope and Charles, that with their lusted love that created the children, they died even with all of these young little ones. They died, and somebody else had to take care of them. So this might have all been going on. Okay, while this is happening, Charles is buried in Westminster Abbey, I guess so. I don't know if it's the Abbey or just somewhere in the grounds. But he's buried there, and I'm not sure where Penelope is buried, but probably same area. This is all Feversham, Kent. And so when this is happening, well, what happened to the records, the birth records of those children? What happened to those? What happened to, like, baptismals? They probably weren't baptized because they were illegitimate. They were probably given, like, oh, no, they're not even allowed into the church. You know, no matter how royally close or linked they were maybe written somewhere else, but maybe not in those papers, so that they might be a problem, these 5-6 children. I'm not really sure about I think his name was Rich. I'm not really sure about him, his assets as a human being, what he did. He may have been a quite interesting fellow, but not interesting enough for Penelope. She just found this Charles to be the one. Now, interesting, we can look at Charles, and he has the V. He's quite a dark-haired fellow, but he does carry the V in his forehead. So that was a good find. It's always a good find to find the V in their hairline. For me, anyway, it just helps match them back. Another insight. But that's all I have, and so I linked that through. I linked the Parliament thing through on the Family Search, and I linked also the Wiki tree. I believe it's called the Devonshire-17 file, which was a conglomerated file from maybe 5 or 10 different files. But I don't know its, you know, veracity of source and greatness. The only thing that I'm having a big problem with also is her death. They're having Ruth's death at 1694, stating that she would have been 94 years old. Now that to me seems a little extreme. Anyway, so that's where we're at, and I don't know. Yeah, it's a puzzle. It's a big puzzle, isn't it? And it's so tedious and so slow that I just can't believe that somebody went clamoring to start charging money for all of this. I did dawn on me, I finally realized the Family Search site is strictly the Mormon database, LDS, and Ancestry is really for, they don't seam them across unless you are LDS. So another one of those is running through. You have to be the LDS to get all of your records going through. So I don't know. They have a lot of weird rules that way. Anyway, it's too complicated out here. The sites are too complicated. They're no fun. Where you just want to add a source, you want to link a source from this site. It's just not happening. There's no ease. It's just not happening. It's a shame too, because it's almost like somebody just put the big foot in the door for this genealogy to stop it in a way. I don't know. Anyway, so I'll try to stick to what I'm doing here, and that's all I can do for it right now. Is I'm going to be editing Family Search. I cannot add the sources that I added to Family Search and then have them swapped over. I did get something called Record Seek, but that's not working going the other way. So I'm giving up on Ancestry right now, and I'm just going to use the Family Search. Apologies to all. I think I handed links out, but apologies to those who have the links of the Ancestry, because I'm not going to use it. I'll maybe use it for back data. You know, I just want to look at a pretty format. But I'm not going to be updating it. It's just too terrible. I may update it if I'm going to really delete a person. I may update it then. Okay. All right, guys.